Macca's Guides.
Hey everyone, Macca here. Continuing on with Thief, this is chapter 6. The chapter is called A Man Apart. And in this chapter, we have 6 total collectibles. This is from the very, very, very beginning of the chapter, as soon as we spawn. I pull out the choke arrow just to take it safe. There is a dog in a cage here, and I put him to sleep just so that he wouldn't really disturb me. You're going to want to move onto your left-hand side to the furthest pillar away from you. Then jump across from this pillar to this pillar, and inside this little bird's nest, there is a collectible. Now, don't let the screen fool you. There is a collectible in there, and you can pick it up. This game's pretty clunky and very picky as to how you pick up an item. So, as you see, I finally do pick it up, and from this point, we'll actually move to collectible 2. So staying exactly where you were from collectible 1, wait for this guy to run his path. If you want to shoot him with an arrow, that's fine too. Not an explosive one, you don't want to cause too much chaos. But once he kind of walks off, you can drop down. I was just keeping my eye on him. Go up the stairs that he was patrolling here, right next to the pillar you were just on. Once you come through this gate, hop on over onto the left-hand side. Watch the two enemies that come running in front of me. And right in the middle of this area, there is a large, like, statue and waterfall. If you climb up this, these two little steps here and go to the base of the statue, you'll find a plaque, and you'll need a wrench to unscrew it, obviously. By now, I really hope you have a wrench. And I'll show you exactly where on the map this is, just so you can reference it if you need. That is where collectible 2 is, in the first little area of the map. Now, moving on, number 3 and 4 you can do in whichever order you want. I recommend doing the first floor first and then the second floor. So, on the first floor, we have our third collectible. You see the hallway right here that kind of connects all the rooms. There are some guards and stuff, so you'll want to keep that in mind. You can do whatever you want with them. I actually just leave them be. But once we come down this kind of main hallway, you'll see them right at the end there. And what you want to do is you want to sneak into the second door on your right-hand side. And that door, I don't know if it's always closed or if I closed it before, but you might want to close it. And then there's a safe inside this room, as I showed on the map earlier, exactly where it is. The code is 889, which is on the screen. Once you put that in, it will open up the safe. And inside there are two objects. One of them is worth some gold, and one of them is an actual collectible, which you see me picking up there. Now, the next one is number 4, quite complicated if you ask me, but this is on the second floor of the mansion. This is before you progress to the next area. If you go too far, you will not get this achievement. Now, I took the stairs to get up here from the top of the map, the north, whatever you want to call it. You can go from either way of this hallway. So I'm approaching it, and it will be on my left-hand side because I'm coming from the top of the map and going down. But if you come from the bottom of the map and go up, there are a lot of traps and stuff, so you'll want to watch out for that, as I showed before me. But once we get into this room, you want to use the painting and find the two switches on the painting to get into this room. Now, starting with the left-hand side lion puzzle, you just want to pick all the pieces that have a red piece in them. And once you pick all the red pieces, that will unlock this left-hand side lion. Now, this right-hand side lion, don't get me going about it. I literally spun it for probably 10 to 15 minutes. I had to cut out the recording, obviously, for you guys, so I know how long I was spinning it. But I'll show you here once I unlock it, and I'll do a really, really good zoom in and focus for you guys to show you exactly what you're looking for, what pieces. One thing I didn't try was to use focus and look at it with my focus to see if there were clues, but that is what you need. They're very, very worn out pieces, so it's very hard to see what's going on. Hopefully, the views that you could see when I was putting it together did help. Honestly, if you just keep spinning it, there's kind of a lot of combinations, so I don't recommend it either. But once you do unlock both of those lions with the right passcodes or whatever you want to call them, you will unlock a jewel there that comes out of the table. Now, moving on to collectible number 5, this is when you are told to go to the ceremony room after a large cutscene. Now, on your way there, You have to go through this door, I believe. We're on the second floor of the house, but this is after the big cutscene in the level. Now, there's this guy. I was going to wait for him. He got on my nerves. I shot him. You could kill all three guys in this area if you want, but as I showed you on the map, there's a painting on this second story before going to the ceremony room. Now, you can walk around, or you can go through this middle room, and once we come outside the room, I actually just passed it, but if I turn around, that painting on the wall right there, I'll show you on my map again exactly where it is. This is on the way to the ceremony room. The painting is on the wall right there. There's a total of three guards. You can take out one, you can take out none, or you can take out all three. It's up to you. Cut the painting with the knife, and it is yours. Now, moving on to more or less the final area of the map, you'll come to this kind of glowing orb thing inside of a cage. I really try not to spoil the game for you guys, because I hate when, you know, a lot of people hate when people spoil the game unnecessarily for them. So there's this orb, and it's in a cage, and you want to make your way up to the right-hand side of it. Keep going up and up and up. You will need a rope arrow. If you don't have any, there is a rope arrow actually in the room right before. If you just search enough, you'll find some rope arrows. Hop onto the rope, scale down a little bit, jump across, and this one's really, really small, so keep your eyes open. The first time I just saw the telescope and actually got to come down here a second time, reload the checkpoint and stuff, but there's a little ring sitting on that crate right there. Anyways, guys, hopefully I see you in Chapter 7. If you did enjoy this, make sure you comment, like, and subscribe so I can keep making videos for you guys. Thanks for watching. Peace!